Black History Month was over. But this is voting time.
All right. All right. Amen.
It's black people's chance.
Yeah. Yeah.
To go to the polls.
Uh-huh. All right.
And be heard. When we let the white America know,
all right,
that we as a people will be heard.
All right, amen.
Come on, talk to me.
Amen.
And so, for those who are 18 and old, lift every voice
and sing. Amen.
Governor Mitt Romney end up getting in. Come talk to me.
All right. All right.
And I know a long time the people feel the politicians are crooked. But the fact of the matter is they all we have.
All right. All right.
Is that right? Amen. And so we encourage you as a people be heard.
Amen.
And so black history must be heard not only during the primaries. Black history must be heard during the general election.
All right.
Amen. God bless your heart. Amen. We're thankful to the Lord, to Reverend Johnson and all of the deacons.
Amen. Bless
you. To all of you, my father's children. Visitors and friends, grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father. And the Lord Jesus Christ is just good to be in the house of prayer.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I'm going to be brief. Of course, I don't feel so well.
All right.
Talking to a person who has sense. Amen. I don't claim to have sense. Amen.
All right.
Amen. So we're thankful to God, so we shall not be drawn. I'm excited.
All right.
Motivated about family and friends. Still looking forward to the day when we can save our families.
All right, amen. All right,
amen. Our vinyl uncle.
All right, amen. All right.
Some of our relatives who are thoughts.
All right.
Still looking forward.
All right.
That's what y'all are most be
pointing. All right.
To the unchurched. It's nice to sit up here in a bunch of church folks and have a good time, sing some songs, maybe do a couple of dances, shout a few times and feel good all over.
Amen.
Of the church rest been trying to save.
All souls. All right. That's right. Amen.
I have never met a person, including myself, who did not have some relatives who was not saved.
All right. All right. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we're trying that's our goal. Amen.
Amen.
So in your invitation, don't just invite those who are at the churches.
All right.
Invite the people you're embarrassed about.
Uh-huh. All right. All right.
Mm.
Amen.
And if you have to loan them a dress or give them a pair of pants.
All right.
Amen. God bless your heart. Tell the person that you tell them God loves you.
God loves you. God loves you. God loves you. All right.
We're certainly grateful to the Lord for our quiet peace.
Amen.
All right.
To lift up our spirits and prepare our hearts for the worship service.
Amen.
We thank the Lord for you.
Amen.
We thank the Lord for each of you who have come to share in this worship service, because without you, this worship service would not be what it is.
All right.
So we thank the Lord for you.
Thank you, Lord.
You.
Amen.
Amen. As one minister once said, with the utmost of brevity, I would like to invite your attention to the Acts of the Apostles. For your consideration, the third chapter, Acts chapter 3, Acts chapter
3.
From his mother's womb was Caleb, who they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple, who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, "Look on us." And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something from them. Then Peter said, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet an ankle bone received strength. And he, leaping up, stood and walked, and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God.
All right.
You may be seated. For a few minutes, I want to talk about this lame man who was at the gate called Beautiful.
All right. All right.
I wanted to share this man's story simply because the Bible suggests that this man had been lame or could not walk ever since he had been born.
All right. All right.
He had never learned to walk. He had never took his first steps. He did not have to worry about anyone expecting him to come anywhere or go anywhere, because he went nowhere by himself.
All right.
I wanted to share with you simply because this is a situation that appears to be hopeless. and does not seem to have a cure or a reverse effect.
All right.
At the cause, it seems hopeless that it did not have a cure or reverse effect, which simply means there was no thought in anyone's mind that this man would ever walk.
Uh-huh. All right.
Since this was in their mindset, what they did was they brought him to the temple of Jerusalem.
All right.
Laid him at the gate called Beautiful, and he would ask alms as folks went inside of the temple.
Uh-huh.
Now, it has been suggested that the gate called Beautiful was on the east side of the temple of Jerusalem.
Uh-huh.
When the text says they went through the gate to go into the temple, what actually happened is they would go through the gate to get in the courtyard of the temple.
Uh-huh.
The courtyard was a big space that allowed all kinds of activities to happen prior to entering the actual sanctuary.
All right.
Because in the actual sanctuary, it was governed, it was ruled, it was operated by the Pharisees.
Uh-huh.
I wish I had.
All right.
I wish I had a witness here.
Amen.
And so this man had to be carried to the gate that is called Beautiful. The fact that it's on the east side means that it is the front entrance into the temple.
All right.
So he was at the front gate waiting for folks to come in. And according to the customs, the Jews had prayer four times a day. I wish I could come somewhere.
All right.
The Jews had prayer four times a day. They would start out at 6 a.m. That was an hour of prayer. They would have another one at 9 a.m. That was an hour of prayer. They would have one at 12. That was an hour of prayer. And then they would have one at 3 o'clock. According to the text, this man happened to be laying at the gate at the 3 o'clock prayer.
All right.
Waiting for folks to enter the Jerusalem temple. Brothers and sisters, you know and I know that church folks are supposed to have a forgiving heart.
All right. All right.
So if they should see a man who cannot walk, if they should see somebody in need on their way into the house of God, in all likelihood, they would give that man. I wish I had a witness.
All right.
But even with all of the donations that he may or may not have received, none of it would help him to walk.
All right, amen.
The text says in chapter 3 that Peter and John went up to the temple at the hour of prayer.
All right.
Now, brothers and sisters, my first question was, why did they go up to the temple at the hour of prayer?
All right.
Because Peter and John were part of the apostles.
Uh-huh.
And you know the apostles had already had their own church.
All right.
Do I have a witness here?
Amen.
Acts chapter 2 suggests it.